Friends, today we are celebrating in India Panchayatiraj Day. What is Panchayatiraj Day? You know, local self-government, the grassroots level democracy in India and throughout the world, it is known as local self-government. There are many definitions regarding Panchayatiraj. Actually, Panchayat is a term which means Pancha plus Ayat. Pancha stands for five, Ayat means control. So in ancient time, this Panchayatiraj means those leaders, five persons especially in villages, they sort out the problems in their own level, and they do not go to court and those you can say kachari, court and court wala thing. And we have to remember this Panchayatiraj system is backbone of democracy. It may be USA, UK, Japan, or anywhere, Spain, India, any part of the globe. Without this sort of grassroots level of democracy, we cannot have a mature and fruitful democracy. The democratic values and the real development, sustainable development, and the project for the upliftment of poor sections of the society can be only possible when we'll emphasize the local self-government or Panchayatiraj. Let me clear, this Panchayatiraj or local self-government started particularly in modern times in India in the year 1959 when late Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru, when he inaugurated the first Panchayatiraj system in Nagaur district in Rajasthan, Rajasthan Indian state, and after that, that spread into entire 29 states, almost all states, and those 3 to 4 states in northeastern states of India, northeastern part, they do not follow Panchayatiraj. However, they also adopt some sort of system like that of Panchayatiraj. Anyway, they have tribal council, all these things. Anyway, this Panchayatiraj has faced lots of struggle. In the initial stages of this evolution of Panchayatiraj in India after independence, it faced lots of difficult challenges. Inside the parliament, it was only in 1992 we got the constitutional status. But before that, there was no such constitutional status for this Panchayatiraj or local self-government in India. Why it is so? Why it became, a very difficult task for those, in that time? Actually, people were not conscious about this Panchayatiraj, and they decided and they represented, and the people's representative, MLAs, MPs, member of parliament, member of legislative assembly, they realized that yes, without local self-government, Panchayatiraj having a constitutional status, without giving constitutional status, we cannot have a proper diagram, proper pattern or plan to implement in India. That's why it took so many years. Anyway, in 1992, when P.V. Narasimha Rao was the Prime Minister of India, at that time, this 73rd amendment, one amendment came, 73rd amendment for rural local self-government. And just after 1 year, in 1993, 74th amendment was implemented, means passed in parliament, towards the urban local government. So we have to remember two things. One is 73rd amendment for Panchayatiraj local, that is rural wala, and 74th amendment for urban local bodies. Anyway, there are so many things to discuss, so it takes lots of time to explain. Anyway, I will give certain things, those articles which are mentioned in Indian Constitution. First of all, we have to remember DPSP, Directive Principles of State Policy. These are the directives which government may put into action or not. We cannot go to court. DPSP, Directive Principles of State Policy. Under that title, we have Article 40. In Article 40, we have you can say Gram Sabha or that Panchayat wala term. And that was there. Article 40 was there till 1992. There was no such article regarding Panchayatiraj. But after 73rd Amendment, after 73rd Amendment, we have a special article 243. There are 395 articles originally in Indian Constitution. We know this. And 243 article especially dedicated for local self-government in India. 243 A, B, C, D, E, F, G, up to D, Z, E, all those articles, nearly 35 articles are dedicated to Panchayatiraj system, that is rural plus urban. So anyway, I will discuss few of them now, and in latter part I will discuss in details. You can get those videos, Panchayatiraj system. We have already those videos on YouTube. You can see it, no issue. But let me discuss 4 to 5 articles which are very important on this particular day, this Panchayatiraj day in India. Thing is that 243 is definition. 243 is definition. How Panchayatiraj is created, and how, what consists of Panchayatiraj, all those ward committees, ward members, sarpanch, pradhan, and the Jilla Parishad, many things we have discussed there. Anyway, and 243A is Gram Sabha. Gram Sabha, in ancient time we know that in Gram Sabha we used to discuss those dispute conflicts and mutually solve those things and compromise those things, whatever there is problem in our villages. And you have to remember that Panchayatiraj is not a new concept. It was there since ancient times in India. In Chola Empire, you can say, in southern part of India, in northern part of India, everywhere Panchayatiraj was there. Even today also Khap Panchayat is there in some parts of India, which is not legal. We should stop that, because when there is constitutional status, we should follow those things, because it's a democratic country. Anyway, 243A is a Gram Sabha, and 243B is Constitution of Panchayatiraj. You people may be thinking, what is Constitution of Panchayatiraj? Don't worry. Actually, inside the Constitution, there are so many Constitution. You'll find Constitution of Parliament article, Constitution of, you can say, Legislative Assembly, Constitution of Local Body, Constitution of, you can say, many bodies. So don't worry that inside a Constitution, how Constitution is there. Actually, Constitution means, what are those ingredients? What are those parts which comprises, that is known as Constitution in this context. However, Constitution itself has large meaning. Or if you want to define Constitution, we can say in a normal sense that it is a set of rules. It's a set of rules, or you can say divine rules or holy document which rules or which is very important to rule one's nation. And people are abide by the moral principles, directives, those articles, those commands which are mentioned in that holy book. Anyway, Constitution. So we are talking about 243B, Constitution of Panchayatiraj. And 243C is a composition of Panchayatiraj. And there are so many articles we'll discuss. So anyway, on this particular day, I just wish, and Vikas Academy wish, that we must have a democratic country, full of strength, energy, and we should achieve development, and we should achieve our goals of democratic values, principles through Panchayatiraj and by strengthening Panchayatiraj or local self-government. This is the message to all of you, and for all those new videos, you can say Panchayatiraj, you can watch me in YouTube. And our academy videos, Vikas Academy, if you see, then if you like, then you will get all those videos. Anyway, thank you very much. Wish you happy Panchayatiraj Day. Wish you happy Local Government Day. Thank you very much. Thank you. Your feedback is very important. Thank you very much. Good day.